Hi, in this lesson today we are about to learn about delivery challan. Delivery challan is termed in multiple names. Certain business will call it as approvals, certain will call it as good receipt note or good issue note, or it can even be called as delivery notes, delivery challan, sale challan. So there are multiple names which have been given to, but all the functionality is same. The core thing is it will not have any impact on accounts, it will have only impact on the stocks. What do you mean by impact on accounts and impact on stocks? When you enter anything in the delivery challan for a particular customer, let's say I'm putting a delivery note for a particular customer, and when I enter 10 products in this with different quantities, the effect on the stock will happen immediately. But on the party's ledger balance, outstanding balance, there won't be any impact. And there will be a track of the pending challans or pending delivery notes which are not yet converted to invoice. So in this demo, whatever name we term, we are going to use the term as sale challan and purchase challan, which is for DC sales or DC purchase. This is what is the term. We are going to use as sale challan, which is for DC sales, and purchase challan, which will be termed as DC purchase. So why does this DC come in the picture? There are scenarios in the business where people will take goods for some approval or for temporary movement in their store. And as per the sales that happens in that store, they will ask us to raise an invoice. For example, one of my relatives have come to my store and he takes 10 sari. So I cannot object there saying pay for the 10 saris and go. So he might say that out of 10, I'll take home and whichever is suitable or whichever is liked by everyone, I'll keep those and remaining I'll return back. Somewhere we need to have a system in place where we need to keep a track that this particular person has taken 10 saris from us. And the stock of 10 saris is getting reduced from the stock. There's even a delivery date in this or a due date in this through which we can track that this person has taken the saris for 3 days. Post 3 days, we can send automatic SMS reminders if we have in our system, if SMS module is configured. Or else we can have a report through which we can call the saris back. After 3 days, if the customer says, I have liked only 6 saris out of 10, for those 6, we will raise an invoice, and for remaining 4, it will get back to the stock. How does that happen? So we have a voucher for delivery challan for issuing the goods, and then we have another voucher, the delivery return challan. Return challan means out of 10, 6 has been kept, 4 has been returned. So remaining 4 sari will take as return, and then once we convert this delivery to invoice, only those 6 will come in the invoices. Even though entire DC is available, when we convert, after the return, only the 6 will be pending and those 6 will get converted to an invoice directly. Now, delivery challan concept also we have in two modes. One is a normal regular invoice mode and second is a POS mode. What do you mean by invoice mode and POS mode? Invoice mode is for wholesalers where they select the product name and then they will type the quantity how many orders required quickly. Whereas retail mode is based on the barcode scanning. So, POS mode is for retail mode. You will use it for scanning purposes. On a retail outlet also, this is the same thing happens where customer takes 10 sari, so they will scan which 10 barcodes are being given to the customer, and then again the return will be tracked as per the barcodes, and even the billing will happen as per the barcode stickers. So first we are going to see the wholesale mode, which is the invoice mode for POS and for delivery challan. So let's say we issue a delivery note. We'll check the stocks that we have for issuing delivery note. Just go to stock summary and I click show. So I have classmate books 100. See, we have certain products like shirts and all which are all barcode based. Saris is all barcode based. So we'll use this for the retail purposes. For currently, since we are using for wholesale, we are seeing an example for wholesale, so we use this products. So classmate 100 pages books, we have 995 pieces in the stock. Let's say I go to this particular and I select a customer name saying, let's say Ashok Opticals. I select a classmate notebook. Out of 995 pieces, how many pieces am I delivering? Let's say 150 pieces is being requested by the customer. At what rate am I giving this? So let's say 50 rupees each, no discount. See, whatever discounts and rates that we give here, as like order, even in delivery challan, we are fixing a rate here. And there will be a print copy of this which will be issued to the customer. We can email that. So that customer also has a track that on this day this much pieces have come to them. And we will also have this track in our system. And whatever rate and discount that you finalize here, the same will be convertible while we convert to an invoice. So we are just, let's say, not giving any discount. And second product, I just gave a Parker pen. I have 4 central exercises, just 70 pieces. Again, at 50 rupees. See, the previous supply rate has just come, where last time it has already been provided at 50 rupees. And for this two, I'm not taking any amount, and I'm just saving this. So it will just generate a print format for us with the caption saying, let's say Saint Chalan Bar delivery note. Okay. And to this customer, we have issued these two products. The details of the same are mentioned below. So this is not having any impact on accounts, but when we see our stock summary and we click show, so this is reduced to 845 and this is reduced to 400 out of 470. And when you see the ledger of this Ashok Opticals, there's no track of this particular DC. Only sale is coming, the DC is not coming here. Now how do we track how many DCs are pending? Let's say we put another DC for other clients saying Rajputana International or Enterprises. There's some pending orders for this particular customer. Orders can also be converted to an invoice, as we've seen in the last session. Here, let's say I just convert these two orders to an invoice, a delivery challan. Basically, I'm not converting to an invoice, I'm converting to a delivery challan. So we have 80 pieces in stock and we have 360 also in the stock. And this order has been converted. As per the order rates, the challan has been converted with those rates. I have saved this. Basically, the order is closed, but now it's a pending delivery challan. How do you see the pending challan report? So you go to pending registers and you see pending sale challan. You click show here. When you see product wise details also, it will give you the product wise details. So for Ashok Opticals, there are two products pending, out of which nothing has been converted to invoice. 150 were provided to the customer as a delivery note. Entire 150 are pending. Okay. How do we convert it to an invoice? As like order, either in DC also we can just go previous and click make invoice. So it will get directly converted to an invoice screen. You can directly save and close the deal. Alternatively, you can go to sales invoice screen, select customer name Ashok Opticals. It will automatically list you all the pending challans. So out of this 150, if you are supplying only 50, and out of this 70, let's say you are supplying 20. So only for this particular, for example, if the customer says in the last week I have sold only 50 pieces of Classmate book and 20 pieces of Parker gel pen, only for that raise the invoice for now. In that scenario, we will just raise the invoice for what he has sold. Remaining, there are chances in the business where he might return it back if it's not moving fast, or he might say that I'll keep it for the extended level. Weekly basis, just raise the invoice for whatever I have sold, not beyond that. This happens in textile outlets also, where a designer comes and keeps the stock in a particular outlet, and the customer who is using Max, he will get the goods from the vendor. He will take a delivery note purchase, for basically a sale delivery challan form on the purchase screen, and from there he will generate barcodes and stick it on the particular pieces and keep it on the shelf. As and when he is going to sell those goods, so only for the sold designs. See, once he puts in the barcode, basically the goods have come inside the inventory, but there's no impact on accounts. And whatever he sells, if he sells 2 pieces out of 10, only for those 2 he will ask his supplier to raise a bill, and for that he will convert it only 2 pieces to a purchase. Similar is the case with the sales also, where we give it to our customers and whatever he has sold, for that only we are raising a sales bill. So I'll just say the sales bill. since the goods have already been supplied earlier, it says supplied goods. This is an invoice, but the goods are already supplied. In case if we are adding two more products in the bill after this 2DC, then it will show you a separate category saying the first two products which are, it will show you the products which are being supplied in the bill at the top, and then at the bottom it will show you a supplied group goods with these two products. So even customer has a clarity that this is converted from a delivery challan. The one who is sitting in your store and packing the goods also will know that this is already supplied. This is no more, I mean, need not be supplied again. This is getting converted from a DC. The DC level itself, the stock has been impacted. Now the accounts have come into place. When you see now ledger of Ashok Opticals, now to show you the sales bill too, 3980 worth outstanding is in the inventory, but there's no impact on the inventory. The impact on inventory has happened from the second transaction of Rajputana, not from the Ashok Opticals. Ashok Opticals part was already the first DC, the inventory was already affected. Now let's say pending challan again. When we see the pending registers, it says 100 pending out of 150 and 50 pending out of 70. This is what we have invoiced already for Ashok Opticals. You can even have the details, you can see the details here. Anyways, the next part of this would be, let's say Ashok Opticals says now this 100 classmate book are not getting sold faster. So you at least take back 60 pieces. Let 40 only be in my store, otherwise unnecessary occupying space. So in that case, what we do, we go to other vouchers and select a delivery challan written. This is a very simple option here. Once you select Ashok Opticals here, it will show you all the pending challans here also, while challan written. We are not taking a sales item, it's a challan item. For example, we have given the goods to our customers and it is still in their store. We are taking back certain quantity back from them. Earlier also there was no impact on accounts. Unless there's an impact on accounts, you're not going to take a sales item. When it's a sale, accounts have been impacted, and then the customer returns back those sold goods which we already converted to an invoice, it will be like a sales item. That has the taxation impact, that has the complete accounting impact. As a part of DC, there's no impact on accounts, no impact on taxation, nothing. Only inventory is just being exchanged here and there. So we have sent 150 pieces, he has sold 50 pieces, and then he finds the remaining 100 are extra and he wants 60 to be written back. So we'll just mention 60 quantity here. Let's say out of this also, another 20 he returns back. So this 80 have come back from Ashok Opticals and we just save this. Okay. Inventory of this is 765 and this Parker gel pen is 40. So we just click show here and this is 825 and this has become 60. Okay, the inventory has changed. The stock has come back to our premises. Now again in the pending challans, once we click show, so it says out of 150, only 40 are pending. Remaining we have supplied, but we have taken back, 40 is only pending to be given. And next time when we convert that particular challan to an invoice, let's say go to this delivery note, click previous and previous. 150 and 70 are marked in bold because this has been converted, we cannot alter this now. And once we convert this to make invoice, only this 40 and 30 are coming, not the complete pending ones. Able to follow? Challan based sales, challan based return, pending challan track, and conversion to an invoice. Only goods movements are happening here and there. There's an impact of inventory happening through the challan, DC sales and challan return. Okay. This is the same way we even have an option for converting this to an in retail mode. This was for the wholesale, where even the pharmaceutical business people with their expiry dates can manage this, and they can track all the goods they have supplied, because in pharma business a lot of times it happens that the supplier has not given the bill but the goods have arrived, even in textile stores and all this many businesses. So they will directly enter the goods, because once goods have arrived to the store, they want to bill it to the customers, and without purchase bill they cannot enter the purchase invoice. So what they do is they will enter a delivery DC purchase. See, what we have seen is an example of sales. The same is applicable in the purchase also, where we get the goods first, like a pharma business. They get the goods first, they will enter a DC purchase or receipt mode, and the goods will get added to their inventory along with the expiry dates. In case if it's having barcode, even the barcodes will get generated while the purchase part itself. And then in case something is written back directly from DC, then they have purchase return challan, or else they will directly make the sales, and once the supplier invoice is in hand, they will convert that particular challan to a purchase invoice. The same scenario that which we have seen for the sale is same applicable for the purchase also. We'll take one example of this also, a quick example. Let's say challan number this, and I'm getting from Deepak Traders, let's say glass made book. I have ordered for 825 is there, I have ordered for another 200 pieces at 25 rupees, and I'm just saving this. This can even be termed as Deepak Traders have given 200 books to kept in our premises, in case that kind of business model is there. Alternatively, we have got the goods, but we have not got the invoice yet. So we are just entering in our system so that we can start billing. Most of the stores will not allow negative billing. And in case if it's pharma, then they'll need to mention all the batch number, expiry dates, and all that details in the system. So they cannot wait for the supplier invoice to come and completely. So that way they will enter the DC immediately and the goods will get added. Post goods are added, it will directly have the immediate impact on the stock summary level, where classmate book out of 825, now it will become 1025. So 200 pieces have got added there. And we can similarly track which all purchase challans for which we are yet to receive an invoice. And you select product wise and show Deepak Traders, this classmate book. Entire 200 pieces are not yet invoiced by the vendor. So once the invoice comes, either we get a conversion to a partial invoice or we can convert to a complete invoice. In delivery challan also, we have a track of other details where we can mention the due date. Based on the due date, we can track or have an expected date of arrival. For example, for the customer also, when we put a DC, what is the due date for it? How many days are we giving it? So based on like sales order, the order has to be delivered within 7 days. Even like for DC also, when we give to the customers, we can mention a due date saying it has to be delivered back or written back in 3 days time or 4 days, as per the communication with the customer. Some customer might say, I have to travel long, I have to show so many people, so I might try selling all your products, and then whatever sold for that you might bill. There are certain agents also who will take 20 saris or 30 saris. They'll try selling from home to home, and then they'll come back after a week's time. Whatever is sold for that, they'll get the billing done, remaining they'll return back. So we can mention a date here, at least 10 days a time, or 7 days time, or 3 days time, however it is. And then we can get this pending challan report with the due dates also. When you get with the due date, we have a track on whom all we need to call back and get the goods back to our store. And same is the case with purchase return challan, where I just select the vendor name Deepak Traders and how many pieces am I returning back. Let's say 20 are found to be damaged. I can return back those 20 right away. Instead of taking it to purchase and then putting a purchase return and having all the accounting part, I will have only 180 which will be coming into the transaction. Remaining will only for this 180 I'll be liable to pay, and all that 20 has been written back. Tomorrow we'll have a complete transaction history on with each delivery challan, that when it has come, when we give show adjustment detail, it will even show you the complete details. You have this plus sign here. You open this plus sign, it shows purchase return challan 20 has been adjusted. So we have a clear track. Tomorrow when vendor says, no, I have supplied you 180, I mean 200, why you are paying only for 180, or why this is 180 has arrived. So we have a transaction date, and on this date we have given back 20 pieces to you. Sometime if there is a confusion, we have a clarity in our system. So the same way, show more than 10 days, show more than 5 days, so it says the overdue. How many days it has been since we have generated this delivery challan? If it's more than 10 days and we are wanting a report for challans where we have purchased more than 7 days and yet the invoice has not come, then we can request invoice to the vendor. Same is the case with our sales challan report, pending sales challan report, where customers whom we have given more than 7 days, we need to call the goods back, and we can quickly find out a report and we can call them back or put an SMS to them. Now all this report have multiple options for filtering. This we have not seen in any other options where we can just filter particular products. Only for this particular product I want to see the challan, only these two products, means I can have filter the two products. All these options can work together for filtering. You can select two groups, you can select particular brand, you can select particular manufacturer. These are all the master level information, product master level information. Or a particular tax code only you want to check for the pending, that also you can check. Similarly, you can select a particular vendor name for whom you are looking. So this general options are available across all the reports. Where you go to options, you can filter multiple account parameters and multiple product parameters. And each parameter can have multiple values again. This two will also work, along with this two will also work. So it will take care that this two brand, this two category only gel pen. So all these parameters, each parameter having multiple values, will be taken into consideration for filtering of the reports. This is applicable across all the reports. There's one option saying do not import here. When you select do not import and click update, this particular challan will not come while converting to an invoice. There are scenarios where certain challan we need to keep it pending. We need not convert it to an invoice till the time we sell it, or sometimes it might be there that we'll have to sell all the goods, then only we'll proceed with the invoicing. So when you give do not import and click update, this particular product of the challan will not get converted to an invoice. It'll keep only, it will be in the pending challan option only, unless we take this remove, I mean take this off and update again. And we have three type of options: pending details, product wise, and all details. So this was with the wholesale part. Let's see the retail part of it. Retail, again there are a couple of concepts which I'll explain you. In wholesale also you go to this pending challan and you can just click make invoice and it will get converted to a purchase invoice. So out of 200 only 180 will get converted to a purchase invoice. I'll just save this part and just mention 50401 sales supplier bill number. So this 200, it is asking for a barcode generation even in the purchase. If it's already generated at DC level, then in purchase it might ask you for the same barcode numbers only, it won't generate a new ones. Now let's see the retail part of it. To enable the retail screen, we'll have to enable purchase return as POS, challan return and other outward vouchers as POS. What happens is, now once we enable this, the retail screens gets enabled. Well, all these vouchers will come in the POS mode now. What do you mean by POS mode? Sales invoice will remain same, purchase invoice also will remain same. Purchase challan will also remain same. Why? Because it will generate the barcodes from here. There's no option of scanning.
Sales return and purchase return also?
Yes. Now there'll be a change in the purchase return where it will come in a scan mode. Same way in the purchase return challan also it will be in scan mode. Why return challan and purchase? Because see, the purchase screen is in the barcode generation screen where it will, once we enter the data, it will generate the barcodes. There's no scanning option required. Whereas in the return challan as well as return screen, you can scan the barcodes once they are generated and you can go ahead with the billing. So let's say example of receipt note here again. This time we'll select a retail product for our the demo purpose. Let's say PTEC sarees, and we are buying sarees product. So it's asking the details of the barcodes. Let's say 10 sarees we are buying at 500 rupees each and the markup is 40, 700 is our selling rate, and we just save this. Now at this level itself it will generate barcodes for us. So 10 unique barcodes have been generated. MA00, 000, 44, 45, 46, this is the barcodes which have got generated in the software. Now when we go for a purchase return, or let's say return challan, now we are ready for sales actually. On the POS, we can directly scan this barcode and start selling the goods because the invoice has already happened, barcode has got generated. In case out of this 10 sarees, if it has come for approval, for example, we have taken from PTEX sarees just for keeping in our premises, and for whatever is sold, for that only we'll ask them to raise a purchase bill. And in that scenario also, we are going to take a purchase like this. Let's say out of this 10 sarees, we have returned back 2 sarees. Let's say this 48 and 49 are damaged or not getting sold, or we find the design is not up to the market, won't get sold in our stores. Then we can just go to purchase it in Chalan and scan the barcode. In purchase it in Chalan mode, you have to select the vendor name, and it will show you all the barcodes available from that particular vendor. It's not a direct scan mode. Direct scanning is also possible, but here we have kept in a different way where you can scan the barcodes here. 45. So MA0045, one quantity has got entered. 48. Let's say these two particular barcodes are being written back. So as per the vendor, only that particular vendor's barcode will get loaded here. Out of that, we can scan in quickly, reject the pieces which we want to return back, and we can save it. So once you have saved, again same case, we go with pending challan and pending purchase challans with product details. Once we give show, it says the pretext 8 sarees are only pending. Remaining 2 did not come at all. They have come in and they have went out. There's no track of the remaining 2. Let's say we have gone 45 and 48. Now once we try to sell 45, it will say no stock available. But whereas when we scan the history of this particular product in the batch movement report, or we want to trace the complete history of this particular barcode, then it will show you that the product has come from PTEX and the output. Basically, purchase challan and return will come next to each other. So this one piece have come in, and again it has went in the return also. So there's no outward as such. Outward will be more for sales or purchase return. Challan mode will get adjusted in the inward part itself, because it's not coming on the other side of the transaction. Okay, same is the case with sale challan now. When you go to Delhi Chalan in the POS mode on the sales, let's say MA46 we have given to a particular customer. These 3 pieces we have given to a particular customer. In Chalan mode, what happens is when we give to a customer, the customer name is compulsory. Whom are you giving this? There is a setting through which customer name may not even be compulsory. I'll come to that scenario. First we'll see this mode. Let's say it's given to Mr. Sumit. Let me save this. So once we save this, there's an option here. Now again the same case where we can see pending sale challan with product details. So we have Ashok Optical, Raj Godhan, even Sumit is added to the line now. And in Sumit we are seeing 3 barcode numbers also along. It says individual pieces. It's not showing 3 quantity. Here how it's showing 80 quantity together. Here since it's a 3 barcode involved, all 3 are shown separately. Same way, if Sumit returns one back to us, we go to Delhi Chalan return and we select the name Sumit. All these 3 barcodes are come. We can scan a particular barcode here, or we can directly type the quantity against each. Let's say the first one is being written back, and we just proceed and save. Now again, when we go to pending Chalan report, only the remaining 2 will be shown. At the back end, inventory is getting added, it is getting reduced. All that is happening with Sumit 3, it has got reduced by 3. Again, when we have taken one back, one sari would have got added again. total 20 pieces are left in hand. When we see double tick this complete history of inward output will be shown. See now today what we have seen is 10 sari inward from PTEX, then 1 inward, basically out minus 1 is happening back, 2 back to PTEX again, so minus 1, minus 1, and 3 went to Sumit. So 3 went to Sumit, 1 came back from Sumit, 10 came from PTEX, 2 we have already sent back to PTEX. So entire history is coming here. Inward of DC return will happen in the same part itself. 10 purchases have come, and since return has happened, minus 1 at the DC level will be shown here, whereas purchase return will be shown on the other side. Same is the case with Sumit, 3 sales have happened and 1 DC return has happened on the sales part. So minus 1 is being shown here. Basically, we are not adding the complete quantity and then reducing it from there. We are basically not showing the extra quantity itself. Instead of showing 10 and then minus 1, we are showing 9 only. Clear? This is what is with the DC. It won't show that we have got extra and then we have returned it back. It's showing that we have not got additional itself. Clear with it? So this is with the sales challan also. We are clear with this. In retail outlets, there is one more additional option where there's one extra configuration that comes in retail outlet. What is the extra configuration? This is connected with DC, so I'm coming to that option. In retail outlets, large scale outlets, they'll have separate billing counters and then separate cash counters. What do you mean by separate billing counters and cash counters? People will bill at one place and then they'll give the slip to the customer, and then there'll be a separate place where they'll go for a payment. So how does that happen? And what is one primary use is to have clear distinction between cashier and biller. If the cash counter person itself will scan and then check the goods and then collect the payment, then the cash counter will be queued highly. The movement on the cash counter will become very slow, which is not a good idea in retail. If it's a small scale store, it is still applicable. But if it's a little large scale store where the movement of the people happens faster, then this will not be acceptable by any of the owners also. They want the cash counters to be moving very fast. So they will have multiple billing counters. Basically, if a store has two cash counters, they might have four additional billing counters or six additional billing counters as per the crowd that comes on that particular floor. If a store is of five premises, maybe the fifth floor might have lesser crowd. So they will have it organized in such a way that the ground floor has extra billing counters, the first extra cash counters also. First floor might have limited ones as per the products that they have on each of the floor. So in that case, so to enable this merge mode option, we call this merging option, where the customer might collect different billing slips from multiple floors or multiple billing counters, and then can come with all those slips in a single counter on POS, on the cash counter basically. And there the user will be able to scan all his delivery slips. See, maybe the first floor is for saris, second floor is kids wear, third floor is, let's say, men's wear, fourth floor is ethnic collection. And if some family is coming together, they might buy multiple things from multiple floors and they might get multiple delivery slips with different products as per the different floors. And finally, they will come to a cash counter with all four or five delivery slips together. All these four or five delivery slips can be merged to a single invoice and cash can be collected together, or cash or card, whatever it is. So let's say this is a delivery slip. To enable that, we have to go to this book setting available and we have to just select POS workflow. So there's an option saying POS workflow setup, which says direct save. Then we have two other options saying hold and save, and third option is hold, check and save. Hold and save means basically slips are getting generated, stock is on hold, and then on the cashier only the POS bill will get saved and the accounts will get impacted. Inventory will get impacted immediately. The third option is where we have this verification happening after hold. The goods are delivered to the customer, and the customer is goods are being billed, and then on a separate counter it is getting verified, and then on the third cashier counter it is being saved. So let's say for this particular scenario, we'll just select hold and save and just save this. Other than this, in this kind of scenario, we even need that the customer need not enter his name. Only on the main cashier counter there might be requirement of name and a mobile number. Whereas on the billing counter, the biller should be able to scan the products quickly and should be able to save and generate the slips immediately. The slips are identifiable by their barcode numbers, which will be designed at the bottom of the print format. So to enable a slip without name, we have to go to the configuration and we have to go to settings. Screen settings. Just a minute. So under screen and validation, we have an option saying account name. We search for setting called allow blank name and you just save. So once the setting is enabled, now the delivery challan will be accepted without a custom name also. So let's say this is one slip which we have generated. I'll select one more slip saying MA00050. Let's say one single product in this and I save this. So it is, I'll have to close the screen and open it again in order for the impact to happen. So 00050 is what we are going to save it. I just save this. So it says, do you want to print? Once we give print, what do you identify here in the printout? You find a new option coming at the bottom. See, it's a 4 inches thermal printing which says delivery sale challan, delivery note. We can even get the counter number, branch name, username, all this date time, everything, along with the barcode number of the product for retail counter. Total items in this particular slip. So it shows one additional option at the bottom saying *61*. The 61 is an internal number of this particular delivery note which is internally generated automatically. In order for the barcode to be printed here, there's a sequence where we are using special fonts, free barcode fonts. There's a free barcode fonts available in Max ERP itself. Those are used for generating barcodes at the bottom of the slip. Currently, when you see the design mode, it will show you a barcode number at the bottom. You can see while designing this a barcode coming here. Instead of that 6168 number, it is showing the barcode fonts. Same output will come while the printout. You need to update the fonts in the system and restart the system once for the preview to get generated with the barcode numbers. So this particular font has a standard where initially there should be a star and then the field name and then a star. This is how we design in the crystal report. While designing crystal report, we have to design in that way so that the number gets generated as a barcode correctly. After this, the next method is, after all this billing counter are done, one number was 58 and the second number is 61, which we have seen. In PO screen, we'll get an option for merging option. So voucher ID was 58. So it automatically says on this counter, this is the bill value, and then 61 or 735. And once we click merge, all the product gets populated for, we can have n number of slips scanned in a single voucher. And then all the products are getting merged here, and when finally we save, the payment is getting collected. Let's say 3000 rupees cash is being paid. And the slip, a POS bill can have all the products again, or we can even have a delivery slip number kind of format where it will just print the delivery slip number, counter name, amount, total quantity. Instead of printing all the products again, it can just have a summary of it and the mode of payment details also. So that is more specific to the retail printing options only, but this is one additional mode for delivery challan. So pending challans we have seen, challan return we have seen, POS mode we have seen, and in POS mode we have even seen a retail options where how billing counter and cash counters are working separately. Billing counters will generate the products with the barcode of the voucher at the bottom, and the cashier counter will just open the POS screen, scan those delivery slips, and all the products will get merged here, and then you'll collect the payments, or any offer scheme discounts will get applied here itself. So that's all. Challan is very important concept in our software as well as on the retail and wholesale businesses. So this is what with all the combinations of challan. Thank you.